There is Illinois and Ohio State. Ohio State sent out a release earlier in the day on Friday saying Ryan Day had tested positive along with some players, but they still had hoped to play today. But then later in the day, as I mentioned, saying they were going to be unable to play, canceled for the second time this season. So it's the fifth straight week we've lost at least one game. Now, remember, the big issue here is eligibility for the conference championship game. You see the cancellations this year in the Big Ten. Let's get you to the eligibility rule, because I think the eligibility rule is really where we want to go here. So let's get you to the eligibility rule, if we could, to talk through that. There it is. Let me give you the basic math here. If the four remaining games are played today, we would need to see 12 of the 14 games scheduled for the final 2 weeks of the season to be canceled in order for a team to qualify for Indy, having played fewer than six games. So if three or more total games are played in the next 2 weeks, you need to have played six to get in. So to clarify, Wisconsin is almost certainly out, barring massive cancellations, and Ohio State would almost certainly be out too if it were to miss any more games. So in other words, if they were to miss a game in the next 2 weeks, Ohio State would be out. Wisconsin almost definitely out at this point. Guys, this is where we are. I mean, this is the story right now. It is how this impacts more so Ohio State. It would be a big story for Wisconsin too had they beaten Northwestern last week, but they did not. And Northwestern is in the driver's seat in the West, and they are deservedly there. What about Ohio State and the impact here on the Buckeyes, Joshua?
Well, I mean, it's a big impact, obviously. I feel like these guys have worked really hard to be in the position that they're in on the field. And, you know, they had a cancellation earlier this year that wasn't necessarily on them. And I think that's going to be the toughest part for a lot of Ohio State fans, probably coaches and players on that team to handle, is they're dealing with their own outbreak right now, which is bad enough, but they had to deal with the cancellation that wasn't necessarily their fault. But it's the reality of the situation that we're dealing with. We all knew what the rules were coming into this year, and whether we liked them or not, that was what was agreed to and what everybody was going to have to abide by. So, you know, you're looking for a little bit of chaos now if you're Ohio State and for some games to be canceled to be in the Big Ten championship conversation. But up to this point, they've won all of their games. If they get back out on the field, they're going to be favored in their games, and they have to control what they can control. It's a very disappointing situation, but it's something that we all probably could have predicted would happen this year, that somebody who was in contention for a Big Ten championship would not be eligible to play in the game due to cancellations because of COVID.
Joshua, you're so right when you think about the fact that you have to be able to control the controllables, and this is what Coach Day has to move to now. He has to make sure that the mindset of his young men and young women that are in the program are now focused on what they can control, and it's difficult. And as you mentioned, these were the rules that were set up. These were the rules that were agreed to. I understand that people now may want to change those rules, but that's not how this works, and it's unfortunate, but this is something that we have to deal with, and as you mentioned, this is something we knew was a possibility, but that was the trade-off for being able to go out and compete this season.
What's most disturbing for me is that the conversation is starting with Ohio State, because Ohio State is the Big Ten's chance, or best chance, to get to the college football playoffs. We talk about Ohio State in terms of going to Indy. The fact that we could have a system that we had a charter on Friday for Ohio State to get on that charter and then get on the charter Saturday morning, whatever the rumors were, what kind of processes have we had? What kind of protocols could possibly bring us to making a decision on Friday? And so if it wasn't Ohio State, I don't think there would be all this conversation. My issue is about the other 13 schools. Are the protocols good enough to protect the student athletes if we can go all the way to Friday before we decide we have a health issue? That's not logical to me.
I would say this, Coach. I don't think we're getting all the way to Friday before we figure out we have a health issue. I think that schools are doing everything that they can to play these games and play them safely. If that means pushing the deadlines a little bit further, then that's what they want to do, because nobody wants to cancel these games, and nobody wants to put kids in harm's way as well. But I do believe that they are trying to do the best they can to get the games played and played safely.
But Howard, how do we know that Minnesota didn't have the same information at the same time that Ohio State did? Right. So shouldn't we? I mean, where do we gather this information? Where is the information consistent? Is it more school-based or is it more conference-based? I would suggest to you that the way it's gone, it's really up to the school more than the conference. So who is responsible for protecting the student athletes, the school or the conference? I think that's the question that should be answered.
Well, and it becomes a little bit difficult, too, when you're talking about college, because they don't necessarily have to do the availability reports, injury reports, and that kind of thing. When you look at NFL, you know who's on the COVID list. You know who's hurt with injuries, this, that, and the third. College coaches don't have to share that information, and part of it is they like to have a competitive advantage. But when you're dealing with COVID, it becomes a really, really difficult situation, because if you're an opposing coach, you would like to know what the COVID situation is, how many players are out, even potentially which players are out, to make sure that all of the protocols are being followed and everything is being done by the book. But here we are again. It's a very strange year. It's a lot of things that are just up in the air and very confusing right now.
And if it is up to the school, why couldn't a school like Wisconsin find another game? I mean, if we're going to give them autonomy when it comes to the health of the players, why can't we give them autonomy whether they want to schedule a non-conference game, which I know we discussed earlier in the season, or to replay the Illinois-Wisconsin game if both of those two are healthy? So it's interesting that the school controls the health issue, but the conference controls the scheduling issue.
It's one of those things. And you mentioned the health. I was going to say, I think that the health of the student athlete first lies at the feet or at the institution, because they are there. They're the closest ones. The conference is a distance away. I think the conference obviously should oversee them all, but it's the responsibility of the member institutions to make sure that they are putting the student athletes in the very best position to not only succeed on the field, but also succeed and be healthy on the field.
You could make a case, Howard, that if my school is healthy, the best thing for the student athletes is to try to find another game, whether it's in conference or out of conference.
But we agreed that there would be no out of conference games.
That's true. Well, how about a reconference? How about Illinois, Ohio State again? Yeah. I don't know that we had that conversation.
Illinois, Wisconsin again. Right.
I'm sorry,
and that might have been a possibility were it not for the fact that Wisconsin or that Illinois didn't find out until Friday night that their game was canceled. I do want to bring up one last point as it relates to Ohio State. So again, they almost certainly need to play their last two games, both of them, in order to be eligible for the Big Ten championship game. But the college football playoff has no such rule, guys. There is no minimum number of games that you need to play to be eligible to be selected into the CFP. And remember one other thing. It's not just the Big Ten championship game this year. We have that entire championship weekend where, at least in theory, team number two in each division is going to play one another, team number three, and so on and so forth. So Ohio State, if they're healthy, would still get a game in championship weekend. It would likely be against Iowa or against Wisconsin, two really good teams that are both in the CFP rankings. So there's no reason Ohio State can't still enhance its resume for the playoff in that final weekend, even if form holds and Northwestern were to make it to Indy, it doesn't get a chance to play Northwestern.